Today we're going to do another junior code review. The code review is about a tiny project a developer did as part of an interview code challenge. Unfortunately, this particular developer did not get the job, and there were a few reasons why. We'll start off by covering the minor aspects as to why he quote unquote failed this coding challenge, and then we'll move on to the two bigger reasons as to why. Hey guys, I'm Dan and this is PixelFix, and I'm here to hopefully help you improve your code by doing code reviews and pointing out common mistakes junior coders tend to make. If you like these kinds of videos and you would like to see more, please hit the subscribe button and also turn on the notifications so you don't miss out when I upload more content like this. Okay, so let's jump straight in and look at the project. The project is a simple application that shows a welcome page with a select dropdown with a bunch of cities. Now, if you click on one of the cities and you click view weather, it'll show a 3-day forecast of that city's current weather. Okay, and now if we look at the code, we can go into the web.php routes file. Now, the first thing you can see here is naming conventions are not properly followed. Okay, so if we look at what this show weather index method actually does is, if we go to the weather controller, you'll see that it only returns a view. So there's two ways we can actually fix this. The first is we can rename this method to index only, and then in here we call the index method. Now this is a better way of doing it in the sense of naming conventions, but seeing that this method only returns a view, this method is basically redundant. So we can remove this method, and then instead of calling a get route or the get method on the route, we can just call the view, and we don't call the controller method anymore, we just call the view. And now if we go back to the web and we select another city and run it again, we'll see it still works. Okay, so another thing we can quickly look at before we move on is cleaning up some code. Now, the developer told me that this API or get API forecast method is an unused method. If you have any unused methods or any kind of unused code, remove them from the code base. It just makes it easier to read, and the code reviewer doesn't need to spend a lot of time trying to figure out what methods do when they are actually unused. Okay, so the next thing we can look at to improving this code is renaming this method. Now, this method, getWeatherForecast, receives the city from the front end, and then it checks or it calls the API to get the 3-day forecast for that city and then returns the results. Now, naming this method could be confusing because from the routes file it is called via a post method, and within here we do some kind of validation, but we're not storing any information, we're just returning it. So what do you call it? Do you call it an index method, a store method, a show, an edit? That's a good question. Okay, so I would say in this case, there's only ever going to be one method in this controller. So we can simply just call this method invoke, which means whenever this controller class gets called or gets initialized, it will automatically just invoke this method or simply just execute the code within this method. Now back in our routes file, what we're going to do is we're not going to call the getWeatherForecast method anymore because it doesn't exist. We're only going to basically call the class or the controller by its name. And now if we go back to the web, we select another city and we view. And there we go, we still get the same results. Okay, so back in our invoke method within our controller, you can see the weather class is being newed up and then assigned to a variable. This is a common mistake junior developers tend to make because we can get rid of this line of code and rely on Laravel's dependency injection to inject that class for us. And again, if we go back to the web, we pick a city, view the weather, everything still works fine. Now again, back in our invoke method within our controller, we can see that the validation is being done inside the method or inside the controller. Now a better way for doing this validation is by creating a dedicated form request. And we do this by calling php artisan make request, and then we call that just weather request. Now what we can do is we can take our validation rules and we can get into our weather request. Okay, and then we can just basically clean up this code and rely on the type hinting the return type. And by default, we need to change this to true because we're not doing any authorization within this request. And we can just return an array. And then what we do is just copy our rule inside the rules method. Now back in our controller, we can now ask Laravel to inject our weather request rather than the default request. And we can remove this line of code. And now if we go back to our web, pick a city, and everything still works fine. Now, as you can see, we've reduced the size of our controller by a significant amount. There's still a few things we can do within the weather service class, which is the class the developer used in order to fetch the results from the API, but we're not going to do it in this review, otherwise it will just take too long. Now this brings us to the first big reason why this developer did not get this job. And the reason is testing. There's absolutely no tests written to test the functionality of this application. And testing is such a big part of the development process these days that if you write tests within your interview or your code challenge, it'll just improve your chances of successfully passing the code challenge just a lot more. Okay, so let's go ahead and write a couple of tests just to show what this developer could have done to increase his chances. Okay, let's create a test by calling php artisan make test, and we'll just call it weather test. Okay, now within our weather test, we can simply rename our default test. We can say it should display the home page. All right, and then what we're going to do is we're going to keep the response that we're going to visit the home page route. We can just call it, see if our named routes work by calling home. And then what we're going to do is we'll just chain this on. We can then assert OK. So we don't need to assert the status 200. We just assert that it's OK because OK is 200. And we can just take that off. And if we're in PHP unit, three tests run, three tests passed. Okay, and that is because we've got the example test, which we can basically remove. And on the unit, we've got unit test as well, that we can remove. Now, if we're on PHP unit, it should say one test, one assertion. Okay, so the next thing we can do is to assert that we actually see something on the homepage, because this assertion only checks whether there was any errors in the response or not. So what we can do is just chain on another assertion. We can say assert C, and then what we want to see is on the home page, we want to see welcome to Weather Wizard. So back in our test, we can just say welcome to Weather Wizard. And now if we run PHP unit again, and we can see everything passes. Okay, so another test we can add is basically to test whether our validation works. So we can say it should return an error when validation fails. And now we can do our post because we need to post to that endpoint. And our route name would be home. And then we're not going to pass any information like the city name to the endpoint because we're expecting it to return an error. So we're expecting it to return a redirect error because it's going to redirect back to the same page. And then we want to assert that the session has a key called errors. Okay, so if we run PHP unit again, and now we can see these assertions were correct. Okay, and then for this example, our last test that we can do is basically it should fetch the weather successfully. And then we're going to post our data to our route home. And then we're going to pass in some information called city. And we're going to say we want the weather for London. And then next we want to assert that the response was okay, got a 200 response. And then we also want to see something on the screen that says that we've got the weather for London. So we can say assert C, and then what we want to see is the weather for London. So we can just say view the weather for London, and then we just copy this because we want to see that on the screen after we run our test. We can just paste it in there. We want to see the weather for London. All right, now if we run PHP unit again, all our tests are passing. Now, for a simple application like this, writing these three tests could have taken this developer maybe 20, 25 minutes or half an hour. Even if he didn't know anything about testing, just to read up or do research about testing, but it would have increased his chances of successfully completing this code challenge a lot more. So, pro tip, guys, please do testing. Write some tests in your code interviews or your code challenges. It's definitely going to increase your chances a lot of successfully completing your code challenge. Now, this brings us to the last reason the developer did not get this position, and that is because the code challenge asked for a front end to be developed in React and Tailwind. Instead, the developer used Blade and Bootstrap to develop the front end. So this means that the developer did not complete the requirements as specified in the code challenge. So my tip for this is, if the code challenge requires you to use a specific technology, and if you've got the time to do it, please do some research and try and use the technology they specified. It doesn't really matter then if your code is not great. At least the interviewer can then see that you've tried to use the technology they want you to use. And not just that, the interviewer can then see you are willing to change and willing to learn a new technology in order to improve yourself. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. And if you liked this video or if you found it useful in any way, please give it a like. And also, if you haven't subscribed yet, please do it now. And remember to turn on the notifications so you don't miss out when I upload more content like this. Until the next episode, guys. See you later.